Today I'm in central Illinois, my stomping grounds. I'm on my way to a very special place. It's where I grew up hunting. I spent a lot of time in those woods with my grandpa and my father. And I still love it there. Today I'll take you along in hopes of killing a few fat squirrels.
It'll be a good morning. Let's go tear them up.
I'll also show you one of the techniques I use to lure them near. I'll call them right down the tree. It works just about anywhere I've hunted squirrels. You might want to try it. It's September, and the hickory nuts are ripe. Most likely that's where I'll find the squirrels today. But it's pretty warm out, which means the squirrels aren't very active. But I can change that by calling them out of the treetops. The squirrel has heard me, and he's coming down the tree now. Squirrels are very competitive, and they get upset when they hear an unfamiliar squirrel in their area. This guy is very agitated. He's coming to fight.
I love it when they come to the call. It's one thing to sneak up on a squirrel, but it's another when you can call him right down to the tree to you. And with a pellet gun, it's really easy. My whole life I've learned how to call squirrels in close, because when I was young, that's all I ever hunted. And to kill them with my blowgun or with my bow, they needed to be really close. And shot him right in the top of the head. He's a young squirrel. You can tell he's got small testicles. A lot like my cameraman. All right, that's one. The animals are moving today. We saw wild turkey, deer. Who knows what else we might spot? Maybe I'll kill a coyote for this is over with.
Scanning the trees for movement, we've spotted a squirrel. He's locked onto us.
I'm not very proud of that one because my cameraman spotted him before I did. We just called a little bit and I hadn't seen anything. Got ready to move and Mattia said, "There's one right there." Sitting there staring at us. Boy, that Umarex is accurate and quiet. Isn't that amazing how he just knocks him around the tree? When I was a boy, I hunted this timber, and it was good squirrel hunting back then as well, but I hunted with a daisy BB gun slash pellet gun. It would shoot either one. And the group was okay, but at that distance, your group was about that big, so I had to get really close to shoot them in the head, and then you had to make a good shot or they would run away. But these Umarex pellet guns are amazing. Just deadly accurate. I got a lot of fond memories in this timber. I just made another one. Plunked a fat squirrel out of the tree.
Another fat red has heard my calling. It's a dirty trick. But boy, does it work.
This time of year, the foliage is thick and heavy, extremely hard to see the squirrels. But what you can see is when they move a limb, or you hear them cutting the acorn, or the, not the acorns, the hickories. These are hickories in here. There's acorns too, but this time of the year, which is 1st of September, the hickories are ripe, but the acorns aren't. So I heard that squirrel cutting. Never could see him. Looked hard for him, but couldn't find him in the tops of the trees. But once I shook the tree, I just shook it a little bit. Then called to him, and he came down and barked at me. And he got slocked. So here's a dead giveaway. This time of year, there's a huge hickory tree right in front of me. I haven't seen any squirrels in it yet, but at this time of the day, there's probably a squirrel in the area. I'm gonna call, or we're gonna bring one in here. I bet I've shot in my lifetime. I've probably shot 30 squirrels out of this tree.
The canopy is heavy. It hides the squirrels. And unless they're moving around, you'll never know where they're at. But when I call to them, the treetops come alive. Squirrels are very competitive, and they get upset when they hear an unfamiliar squirrel in their area. This guy's very agitated. He's coming to fight.
That squirrel took a long time to come down the tree. If you're patient, when you bark to them and shake the tree, then you just hold still. Eventually, curiosity kills the cat, and they come down to find you. And when they do, they get their brains blown out.
Look at that tiny little track right there. Look at that.
That little deer probably doesn't weigh, I'm guessing 20 pounds, 25 maybe, about the size of a coyote. But this is a cool little place right here. When I was a kid, I'd come here and play in the creek, catch chubs and find crawdads. But I like this spot right here because this is the first place in my life when I was about 6-7 years old that I found my first arrowhead. The Indians had dropped it or lost it here, and a little black arrowhead about that big. You can only imagine what they went through to kill squirrels. But the Indians, they didn't do it. I mean, it was fun probably, but they didn't do it for fun. They did it to stay alive, and heck, they'd even climb the trees at night and kill them in their nest and do whatever they had to snare them. You know, anything they could do to get food. And there was plenty of them back then, I'm sure. There were gray squirrels back then in this area, but they've since vanished. Now there's other locations you can hunt them. There's lots of them in different places, but here in central Illinois there was very few, and they're just now starting to show back up. Along with the pileated woodpecker, they weren't around. Now they're back. It's kind of a good thing. Time to head back to the cabin and get the cold steel out and get to cleaning squirrels.
So, just like my grandpa, I ran over a squirrel. I didn't have my limit, but I just ran one over. It was an accident, because I don't like running over any animal, but no reason to waste him.
If you're a squirrel hunter, you probably already know how, but I'll show you how I clean them. So, you peel all the hair right off the back of their tail, cut right through there. You want to use a fillet knife when you do it. That way you can get down that skin along their back. So once you
remove the bone, you leave that skin on there like that. You put the heel of your boot or anything on there, like that. And you pull up on the squirrel. It comes off like a pair of socks. Just take that meat like that, the front leg, and this back, both legs.
Okay, so take that V of skin right there, but just grab the end of that, all right? Get a hold of that, hold his legs together. You take the top pair of socks off. Take that like that. Oh, there you have it. And you just cut him up like any animal. You keep the hind legs quarter off the hind legs and the front legs, and then you can keep the back, and it's all good to eat. Grandpa used to eat the kidneys and the heart, but I'll be good with just the normal meat.
They eat, but one would be all I want.
Okay.
Yeah. Let me get the sack.
Come on in. This is where my dad hangs out.
Dad, I see you cleaned up the place nice.
Oh, yeah, not yet.
With all this work cleaning squirrels for Dad, and he only wants one.
Love to know.
You want me to leave these, you want me to leave these on there for you?
No.
Grandpa always liked the kidneys.
Well, it works if you boil the pits out of them.
This is my dad. He's 107 years old.
Oh!
108, sorry, I got my numbers wrong, but he's doing good. So, the elk season just started. Dad's got a high fence elk hunting place here in Illinois, and guys come here all the time and get their freezer
elk,
full.
Yeah. Elk, red stag, fallow deer.
Yep.
Yeah, fun.
Yeah. He won't let me shoot him, but he lets everybody else shoot him. Makes it said I gotta pay too.
Yeah, right. It's a money-making deal, I hope.
What do I owe you for them squirrels I shot in your woods today?
Man, alive, they're nice too.
Yeah, yum. Yeah. I called them down the trees, Dad. They came down and were barking at me.
Yeah, well, that's fun,
isn't it? Dad taught me how to kill squirrels. Unfortunately, I think the limitation time is over, but he used to take me in June when they were in the mulberries, and they don't come in season until September, Dad.
Oh, I didn't know that.